players are going to see a lot of new things. They're going to explore different experiences, but they're always going to be in Camelot and exploring that world.
The fact that we've chosen to go 3D with this game, it sets us out from a lot of other games out there.
We received an amazing creative freedom.
We can create these really expressive, fluid and smooth animations. And we can show that from, you know, any angle and reuse them in so many different ways.
We love the show, we respect its creators, but more importantly, we want to make sure that the players of the game are going to enjoy what we provide to them.
I want to see what's behind that wall, I want to go deeper into that world, and I want players to be able to explore the things that interested them in the show.
It cannot only be a copy of what people have already seen in the show, it has to be a meaningful extension of the Merlin universe. Playing a good game by yourself is good fun. Playing with other players, with your friends, just becomes an amazingly good fun.
You look at the imagery and you know straight away that, yeah, this is Merlin, and this is something fresh and exciting within that universe. Getting the characters and actors' likenesses into the game has been absolutely great fun.
When designing a Merlin game, there are these three pillars. There is heroism, camaraderie and adventure. If it's not doing at least one of those things, then it shouldn't be in the game. You're going to be interacting with all these kind of interesting situations that fit the show and expand on what you've seen in the show.